Good morning, my dear students. So in continuation from chapter 2, let us learn the division algorithm for the polynomial, which is the last topic of your chapter. So already we know that from primary classes only we are learning that dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So dividend is given by P of x equal to divisor is g of x, quotient is q of x, and remainder is r of x. So if you are given a question that define the division algorithm, you have to write this equation and this condition also, that your remainder r of x is 0 or the degree of r of x should always be less than the degree of g of x. Suppose you will be given one question, divide 3x square minus x cube minus 3x plus 5 by x minus 1 minus x square and verify the division algorithm. So whenever you are given any equation, first of all your power, highest power should be written before. It's not in the ascending order or in the descending order, the highest power, then you have to write the equation, then you have to look into your divisor. Here also divisor is written, not systematically written, so you have to arrange it, and after you apply the division algorithm, here you are getting your remainder to be how much? 3. That means this is original is your dividend, this will be your divisor, this is quotient, and this is remainder. Now to verify, we are using what? We are using our right hand side, that is multiplying g of x into q of x plus adding the answer with our remainder r of x. And when you are getting, you are getting the value that is your original p of x. So related to this, so you have a here also one important question, that is find all the zeros of this polynomial if you know two of its zeros are root 2 and minus root 2. As I have already told, depending on the highest degree there are the zeros. For example, here I have already discussed that when your degree is 1, you will have 1 0. When there is degree is 2, you will have 2 zeros. When you have degree is 3, you will have 3 zeros. And when degree is 4, you will have how many zeros? 4 zeros. But out of this 4 zeros, 2 zeros are already given to you. So here you have to follow 3 steps to solve this answer. So what we are doing, since it is given two of its zeros, that means one value of x is root 2 and another value of x is minus root 2. So bring this root 2 here, this will be minus root 2. Then bring this minus root 2 on your left hand side, you will have plus root 2. After that, what we will do is multiply it. Okay, multiply both the left hand side, so it is coming a minus b into a plus b, that is a square minus b square. So x square minus 2, you are getting it, and this will be your divisor, this will act as your divisor. Okay, and the given polynomial function will be your dividend. Then you have to apply what method? Division algorithm method. Okay, so you have to divide it. Okay, and while you divide it, one thing you have to keep in mind, that always in this answer your remainder should always comes as 0. If your answer is not coming as 0, that means you have done mistake in your division. Okay, so whenever you are getting this type of question, your while you are dividing the dividend with your divisor, your remainder always should come as what? 0. Okay, this is your second step. And the last and the third step is, what you have to do is simply you have to factorize your quotient. Why? Because in your quotient part you have degree what? 2, and from here you will get the another 2 zeros. So if you see here 2x square minus 3x plus 1, we have simply applied our factor theorem, that is your middle term splitting, is not it? And while you are spreading, you can see here our answer is coming as 2x minus 1, that means 1x value. So after that you have to compare with 0. So one x value you are getting as half and another x value you are getting as 1. Therefore the other two zeros are half and 1. Okay. So in this chapter, these are the important questions and the topics.